The most important concept to take away when learning to wrap handlebars is to always, always, always wrap in the direction that the hand will be gripping on. So when I was moving my hand in that wrap direction, that's the direction the hand will be gripping on, just like I'm doing when I'm holding those bars. So that's the biggest takeaway from this video. So as you get ready to wrap your bars, do that. Visualize the way your hands are gonna wrap around the bars. Like if you're gripping the bar and you apply downward pressure, which way is the direction of rotation? And that's the way you wanna wrap your bars, that direction. So with the Malaco bar, it's fairly open-ended. And we're gonna start by just cleaning this bar, even though it's brand new, get any oils off of it. So we're just using some isopropyl alcohol on a shop towel and rubbing down all the surfaces we'll be wrapping with tape. All right, now that our bars are clean and we visualize the direction of pressure so we know which way to wrap, I'm gonna start at these bar ends that are open and leave just a little bit of excess cork, which is a synthetic product actually, so that I can tuck in and be replaced with the cork topper at the end. And in this case, I'm rolling towards the outside of the bar so that when my hand grips in that direction and applies pressure down, it's gonna tension the wrap. So that's the core concept repeated again. The other technique, which is important, is that once you start wrapping, you always maintain the tape tension. So that's what I'm doing there with my thumb as I go around those welds. Just trying to maintain even tape tension across the wrap. I love you. Sentimental reasons, I hope you do believe me. I'll give you my heart. Okay, we can see that we're nearing, oops, lost that tape tension for just a second there, so we got to reset that. Anyway, we can visualize the end of this wrap, so went ahead and just cut off the grip tape accordingly, and then I'm going to use a little piece of tape that came with the grip tape and then finish it with Gorilla Tape because it's just much stronger and I appreciate the feel of Gorilla Tape on my hands while biking. The other thing to observe here is I'm taping the bar tape with the finishing tape in the direction of rotation. So that will help maintain the tension as well. Here I'm just resetting the cork. You can also use champagne stoppers if you file them down. I've done that on other bikes and I think it looks pretty cool. But I'm using traditional wine corks here just for a chance to change it up and see how it goes. Okay, we're gonna wrap the next bar segments. Same thing, visualizing the direction of rotation of the tape and making sure that's equal to the direction of force while gripping this segment of the Malaco bar. So that's going to wrap towards me, because if I'm gripping this, I'm going to be pushing down. And there we go. We're just going to wrap it until we get to the end and tape it off. Good way to keep the tape tension while you let go of the tape. I should note this is my first time wrapping a Malaco bar. So if you've done this a lot and you're watching this video and you have feedback, please let me know. Or if you've just seen something that you think I could improve on, please put that in the comments below too. So I repeated the same process, wrapping the last two segments, starting at the center of the bar, and there's the final product. If you like this video, the best way you can support me and the creation of more content like this is to donate $5 to the PayPal link below. Thanks for watching, and happy bike riding.